Solve the system of linear equations by graphing. And they give us two equations here. 5x plus 3y is equal to 7, and 3x minus 2y is equal to 8. When they say solve the system of linear equations, they're really just saying find an x and a y that satisfies both of these equations. And when they say to do it by graphing, we're essentially going to graph this first equation. Remember, the graph is really just depicting all of the x's and y's that satisfy this first equation. And then we graph the second equation, that's depicting all of the x's and y's that satisfy that one. So if we're looking for an x and a y that satisfies both, though that point needs to be on both equations, and so or it has to be on both graphs. So it'll be the intersection of the two graphs. So let's try to see if we can do that. So let's focus on this first equation, and I want to graph it. So I have 5x plus 3y is equal to 7. There's a couple of ways we could graph this. We could put this in slope-intercept form, or we could just pick some points here. You just really need two points to graph a line. So let me just set some points over here. Let's say x and y. When x is equal to 0, what does y need to be equal to? So when x is equal to 0, we have, let me do it over here. We have 5 times 0. Plus 3 times y is equal to 7. That's just 0 over there. So you have 3y is equal to 7. Divide both sides by 3. You get y is equal to 7/3. Y is equal to 7/3, which is the same thing as 2 and 1/3 if we want to write it as a mixed number. Now let's set y equal to 0. So if we set y is equal to 0, so when y is equal to 0, we get 5x plus 3 times 0. Is equal to 7, or this part right over here just becomes 0. So you have 5x is equal to 7, divide both sides by 5, and we get x equals 7/5. X is equal to 7/5, which is the same thing as 1 2/5. So let's graph both of these points, and then we should be able to graph this line, or at least a pretty good approximation of that line. So we have the point 0, 2, and 1/3. So 0, and then we're going to go up 2, and then 1/3. So that's that point right over there. So that's 0. I'll call that 0, 7/3, right over there. And then we have the point 7/5, 0, or 1 2/5, comma 0. So 1 2/5. 2/5 is a little less than a half. So 1 2/5, comma 0. So our line is going to look something like this. I just have to connect the dots. I'll try to draw it. It's always hard to draw the straight line. I'll draw it as a dotted line. So it would look something like this. Normally, when you have to solve a system of equation by graphing, they normally give you a little bit cleaner numbers. But we'll try our best and see if we can see where these two lines intersect. So now let's worry about the second one right over there. So we have 3x minus 2y is equal to 8. So I'll do the same thing. So 3x minus 2y is equal to 8. We'll just look at the x and the y intercepts. So first the y intercept. When x is equal to 0, this whole thing boils down to 3 times 0 minus 2y is equal to 8. That's just 0. So you have negative 2y is equal to 8. Divide both sides by negative 2. We get y is equal to negative 4. So y is equal to negative 4. So the y intercept is 0, negative 4. Right over here. Let me mark it 0, negative 4. And then let's set y equal to 0. So when y is equal to 0, this term right over here just becomes 0. So we get 3x minus 2 times 0, so that's just 0. So 3x is equal to 8. Divide both sides by 3. You get x is equal to 8/3. X is equal to 8/3. And 8/3 is the same thing as 2 2/3. So 2 2/3. So it puts it right about there. That's the point 0 8/3. Now let me try my best to graph it, connect these two dots. So let me do my very best. I'll do a dotted line there. It goes something like that. And just eyeballing it, it looks like these two lines intersect right over there. I'm hoping that this will give us a clean answer. And this is the point 2 comma negative 1. So that is the point 2 comma negative 1, right? The x value here is 2, y value is negative 1. Now that's what we got just by kind of eyeballing it, and clearly these are hand-drawn graphs, not very precise. Let's verify, or let's see, if 2 comma negative 1 does satisfy both of these equations, if it's an x and y value that satisfies both and lies on both graphs. So if you put 2 comma negative 1 in this first equation, you get 5 times 2 plus 3 times negative 1. And we're going to see if that is equal to 7. So this is 10. 10 plus negative 3. So that's the same thing as 10 minus 3. Does that equal 7? And yeah, it does. 10 minus 3 is equal to 7. So 2 comma negative 1 is definitely on that graph, or it definitely satisfies that equation. And then let's do it with the other one. So if we do 2 comma negative 1, you have 3 times 2. Minus 2 times negative 1, and we're testing to see if that is equal to 8. So 3 times 2 is 6, and then 2 times negative 1 is negative 2, but then we're subtracting that, so it's 6 plus 2. 6 plus 2 is equal to 8, and it definitely does equal 8. So we have the coordinate, or we have the x, we have the point 2 comma negative 1 satisfying both equations. So we've solved the system of linear equations by graphing.